We've been spending the 4 o'clock hour talking about, well, surprise medical bills, and people have been calling with real life examples of how some of these bills have either hit them or could have hit them in worse ways, and talking about how health insurance fits into all of that. And now we bring on our special guest here, U.S. Senator Bill Cassidy, as he has some legislation that is dealing with surprise medical bills and ending gag clauses preventing patients that prevent patients from knowing the price of health procedures. So, Senator Cassidy, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us today.
Hey, Brandon, thank you for having me, and thanks for taking on this topic. It's an important topic.
Yeah. Senator Shannon Wilkerson here, and as Brandon just said, one of the things that you're taking on is gag clauses, and introducing the Know the Price Act is your approach to being able to make some corrections, make some improvements with that. And that, you know, for our listeners that aren't familiar with what a gag clause is, that's a contract between healthcare providers and insurers that restricts patients' access to price information. And it's one of those things that I think most people in the public are unaware of when it comes to healthcare, that these types of deals actually do exist, where there is a concentrated legal effort that prevents patients from actually knowing that there are other more affordable options out there available for them.
Absolutely. I mean, we got to give the patient the power. I am so totally against single payer, but if you're against the government kind of dictating everything, you got to be for the patient having the power of a transaction. And one way is the power of price. Let me give you an example, Shannon. You want a colonoscopy. Maybe you don't want a colonoscopy.
I really don't. I have to get one, Senator. It's funny you brought that up, because I'm 54 and I haven't had one yet. And every time I go to the doctor, he says, you better go get a colonoscopy. And I keep putting it off. So it's ironic that you brought that up now.
If you're 45 or above, you need to have one.
Well, there you go.
And if you haven't had one, now I'm just taking a break and being a doctor. You need a colonoscopy. You ought to do what Beto O'Rourke did with a dental appointment, live FaceTime it, but get some press out of it. You need a colonoscopy.
Yeah. Thank you, doctor. Thank you. Yeah, let's move on.
So you can go to an ambulatory surgical center in-network, and it costs you $1,500 soup to nuts. Let's just take the example.
All right.
You go to Hospital A, it would cost you $3,000. And in Hospital B, $4,000. Each one of those is in network. Mm-hmm. Clearly, if your copay or your coinsurance is 10%, you want to go to the ambulatory surgical center.
Sure.
You should know that difference in price. $1,500 here, $25,000 or $33,000 there, and $4,000 the other place. You should know that. And if the patient's going to have the power, you should know that up front. So we're all about you knowing that up front.
Yeah, well, you know, we shop online for everything else and compare prices with everything else practically in our lives. If you're shopping for a vehicle, you're looking at, you can go to lots of different websites to be able to compare what's available at different dealerships and compare the prices. So that what we're talking about is our body, which is a lot more important.
It is, and I will say the patient does best when you consider both their financial health and their physical health, because you really can't separate the two. If you're burdened down by medical bills, I mean, that can be crushing to your health. And doctors are trained to be your patient's advocate. So if you get a good working relationship with a doc, and maybe you don't know the best place, but your doctor knows the best place to have a certain procedure, then she or he can guide you. But it should be good for your pocketbook. It should be good for your health. And one way to do this is a price transparency. A good example. A few years ago, there was an article in the Los Angeles Times about the cost of a CT scan in the L.A. Basin. Mm-hmm. The cash price ranged from $250 to $2,500. Wouldn't you want to know that on the front end? We think the patient should have the power of price.
We're spending time with U.S. Senator Bill Cassidy. Now, real quickly, before we move on to the surprise medical billing legislation, I do want to mention what you've been talking about here when it deals with the Know the Price Act, especially when it's talking about dealing with hospitals. There was also some legislation that went into effect last year that you were a huge part of that would basically ban pharmacy gag clauses as well. Can you briefly explain how that is something that could be very beneficial to our listeners now?
Pharmacy benefit managers are kind of the insurance company between the patient and the insurance company. They were going, at least one of them was going to independent pharmacists and said, look, it might be cheaper for the patient to pay cash, not their insurance copay or their coinsurance. But if you tell the patient that, they can ask you, but if you volunteer the information, we're going to cut you off from your contract. What? Yeah. The pharmacist is supposed to be the patient's advocate, but now they're kind of cut off. So I mentioned that to a guy down in Metairie. We're having coffee. He goes, hey, I go in to get a blood thinner, and it's going to be my coinsurance is $190. And I said, $190? How much have I paid cash? And well, since you asked me, I can tell you, if you pay cash, it's $70. He was paying $120 more to be in his insurance plan as opposed to paying cash. Now the pharmacist is no longer gagged. Mm-hmm. The pharmacist can now tell the patient. And by the way that law came into place, and you can look on YouTube, there was a pharmacist from Hammond that came and spoke to me in D.C.
Yeah.
He goes, listen, I'm not supposed to tell you, but I'm going to tell you. And this is the problem. And, I forget his name, but it's a pharmacist in Tangipahoa. Mm-hmm. He's got a little place on his website. You can download the YouTube where he's got an interview with Lee Zurich out of New Orleans.
Yeah.
Great interview. He had the courage, if you will, and now patients are saving money.
All right, yeah. Senator Bill Cassidy is you're speaking with, and we've only got about 3 minutes left, so we got to get this in. The Stop Surprise Medical Bills Act. Now, this is something that's gaining quite a bit of momentum, bipartisan legislation. There's now at least 14 senators, I believe, that are involved in this legislation. We were talking about this a little bit earlier, where it's talking about there's different levels of services that are provided to patients in the sense of out-of-network costs that get associated or that get thrown in there that are a surprise to these patients who believe that they're covered, but there's out-of-network, say, facilities that come into play or services, and they're getting these surprise medical bills that are coming into play. And basically what's happening is the patient is becoming kind of like the middleman between the providers and the plans themselves, and they're having to absorb those costs. Tell us a little bit about this legislation and what you're doing to help, again, save money for people that need it the most.
Yeah, Brandon, you said 14. We now have 20 senators who are on board.
Wow.
And what we do is we just take the patient out of the equation. If you go to an in-network facility and have surgery, but it turns out that a piece of equipment they used is out-of-network, believe me, you may not have out-of-network, you don't get a bill. You get an in-network bill. The other thing we do is if you are in an emergency situation and you go to an out-of-network facility, you're treated as if in-network. Now, the doctors, the hospital, and the insurance company may go after each other, but you're out of the equation. You pay your in-network fee, you're out of there, and then they go at each other. If they can't resolve their differences, they go to arbitration. But the patient never knows that because the patient's been taken out of the equation.
Yeah, that's terribly frustrating. You know, it's great to hear from you. Always good to have you here on Offside, Senator. I'll think about the colonoscopy, okay? If it makes you feel any better, I'll at least think about the colonoscopy and try to get that done. How's that?
If I got a minute more, there's a former LSU basketball player that walked out of the doctor's office 3 times saying, oh, I've taken the prep, but I don't want the colon. And then he ended up.
What happened?
So I don't want to be a downer, Shannon.
What ended up happening to him?
What
you
happened?
Broke up.
Yeah, you were breaking up.
Yeah, he 3 times he took the prep, or twice he took the prep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Twice he walked out without getting it. So I don't want to be a downer because he ended up having colon cancer.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Good Lord.
I will call one of my good friends in Lafayette, and I will get you an appointment within a week, and you can have your colonoscopy in 2 weeks. They're going to dope you up so great, you'll not remember a thing.
I better not remember a thing. Senator, I mean, all due respect, I don't want to remember any of that. Thanks for joining us. We'll be right back here on Offsides.